One of the really cool things in the Uber thing, press that thing, and then his screen goes green and he knows it's you. Vous étiez dans l'armée?
In Amsterdam, you don't have to wear a mask. Also, when you're traveling for like 2 or 3 hours, it's nice to not be overwhelmed with content. You know, if you have like 20 podcasts to listen, instead just you have one thing, then you'll end up doing that one thing. So before traveling, pick one thing that you're gonna do.
My one thing was Dutch phrases on Anki Droid, and here's how I set it up. Anki is a flashcard software that I've really come to love, and while you can do this next part on your phone, I really prefer doing it on my computer because I like to sit down and study on my computer. Fire up Anki Droid on your computer, create an account if you don't already have one, and then hit add. Make sure to create a new deck before you begin your study and name it according to your area of study. For the rest of this video, I'll follow along with my Dutch deck. Just choose the word or the phrase that you're expected to remember and a quick explanation of what it is in the language you understand. During your study hour, you can just keep enriching your deck without worrying about anything else. When you're done with the study hour, close this add window and open the browse window. Here, pick up your deck and take a quick look at all your entries. Make sure that your fronts are in Dutch or whatever you're expected to remember, and feel free to mix it up a bit. You'll see some of these are nouns, some of them are verbs, and I've also added verb conjugations over here because real life situations are not going to be so organized. You'll get one thing and then the other. You should be ready when things come a little mixed. That's it. That was easy, wasn't it?
If you're clueless about the material that goes into this deck, then I've made a video about just that in this episode over here. Check it out if you need some inspiration in collecting the material for your first deck.
Studying a new subject is only the first part of your learning journey. It has to do so much with discovery, and you lose most of it in a week's time. To combat this decay, you have to review your material in a day or two and then do it again and then again and again and again. You'll see that this curve gets flatter and flatter, less steeper the number of times you review your material. So over time, you retain more information, and also you need a lesser frequency of reviewing your material. So it's a lot of work the first time around, but as you keep doing it, your vocabulary or the information tends to stick and it remains in your head. If you enlisted all the English words you knew from the dictionary and just made a list of them on an Excel file, you'll be amazed at how many words you know. But showing this list to a kid who's just learning English and tell him that you need to remember all these words, it feels so intimidating. I spoke about this repetition principle in my TEDx talk stemming from my success of learning the French language. I'll leave a link to it over here and in the description, so check it out if it interests you. I even used Anki to ensure I retain the huge amount of information I had to consume for my first job here in Paris. During this month, I consumed hours of videos which introduced me to the principles of data warehouse management and business intelligence. So this isn't exclusively for languages, it works for anything that has to do with retaining a lot of information. I've spoken about my French learning journey in this video over here, but back then I was not using Anki. For the last 2 years, I've used Anki for work and also to memorize and master French expressions, because that's another ocean in itself. I'll be posting videos on here about my Dutch learning journey as well, so definitely subscribe to be in the loop. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you guys in the next one, and as always, Black Fleur. Oops, I did it again. I did it.